Coach Willie Taggart from USF on the line. The Bulls are 2-8 overall, 2-4 in the American Athletic Conference. Last week, USF was in action against SMU. SMU won the game 16-6. And the Bulls, again, back on the field this Friday at UCF. That will be an 8 p.m. Eastern Time start and will be on ESPN. Coach, thank you for joining us on the call. If you could take a minute to tie up the game against SMU and then tell us what you look forward to as you head down I-4 to face UCF on Friday, please.
Well, in the SMU game, I thought my defense came out and played outstanding and did a good job of containing SMU's offense, which was high-powered. And I thought special team, we did well. Offensively, we continued to struggle to try to put points on the board, and we got to do a better job of just finding ways to score points and not hurt ourselves. I thought when we got things going offensively, we shot ourselves in the foot with some kind of penalty. And then when you get on the one-yard line, you just got to find a way to score.
I'll take questions for Coach Willie Taggart. Please, star one on your telephone to join the queue, and then the operator will introduce you. Again, star one for questions, please, for Coach Taggart.
We'll go first to Joey Johnston with Tampa Tribune.
Willie, how do you go about impressing on your players the importance of this game with UCF and what it means? I know you haven't played since 08 and you weren't involved, neither were they, but how do you convey whatever history there is and also the importance moving forward of this game?
Well, we show that guys some of the film from back there, some of the highlights and things from back when the rivalry was going on. We showed our guys that yesterday. We kind of showed them the significance of this game, the importance, and the way that the crowd is going to be, how everybody's going to be into this football game. It's something that they all need to know. I know they hear it, but they don't see it. And luckily we had that highlight in the film to be able to show them the environment and the rivalry and how intense this rivalry is.
They obviously have a great quarterback in Bortles. Can you speak about what you guys are going to have to do to defend them, how you're going to be successful at defending them?
Yeah. We've got to continue to play well defensively. Our front four got to play outstanding. I thought our guys up front played very well this past game. And we got to do a great job this week. Bortles is really smart, very elusive. He can get some first down with his feet, but he's so confident in what they're doing. And he's got a good group of guys around them that make plays. You know, they're a very well-coached football team, and you very rarely see those kids out of position, and they play with great effort. So it's going to be a challenge, but our guys got to come ready to play, do a great job of understanding the game plan, and then just play with fanatical effort.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
We'll go next to Jeff Hartman with Tampa Bay Times.
Coach, as you know, there were many years when these two teams didn't play, and it may not have necessarily benefited USF to play UCF back in the day. But since you came on board, is this a rivalry you kind of embraced? Do you like the idea of, you know, playing a team right down the road?
Yeah, I love the idea of playing them. I think it's going to be great for our conference. It's going to be great for our state. It's going to be a good rivalry. You know, I'm looking forward to it, excited about it. I can tell from when I first got the job the importance of it all. I mean, we wasn't even playing them yet, but you skip over the other games to talk about the Central Florida game, so you know the importance of it for our fans and our alumni. And, excited. This is what college football is all about, you know, and it's great that you get an opportunity to be a part of something like this.
How important is a game like this in terms of recruiting?
That's huge. I mean, because there's going to be a lot of guys that you recruit against, you know, I mean, that you're recruiting to try to get in. It's big. It's huge when you play in a rivalry in your state, just and then you're in the same conference. So it's huge.
Take the next question, please.
We'll go next to Paul Tenorio with Orlando Centennial.
Hey, Willie. Do you get a sense from the fan base or the student body that maybe there would be just kind of how important or how nice it would be for them to maybe play the role of spoiler for UCF? You know, obviously they need probably two wins here, so to not to capture the championship and play in the BCS Bowl. Do you embrace that kind of thought and mentality? Is that prevalent down there right now?
I think I embrace more the fact that they want to beat UCF. You know, not necessarily just to spoil what they have going on, but just the fact that you're playing against them and you want to beat them. You know, you get excited about that, and you appreciate that your fans and your students and everyone get fired up about that game and win that game. You know, you can see it all the time. I walk them off in the mound, and I see some students, and the first question they ask, "You gonna beat UCF?" You know, they all excited about it. And not because we can spoil what they have going on, but the fact of the matter, we're playing UCF. So, I appreciate it. I enjoy it and look forward to it.
This is a UCF defense that right now at times is playing five true freshmen on the field at once. What have you seen from them on film? What do you think is maybe the best way to attack them, or what you feel you guys are going to have to do successfully in order to get them out of that rhythm a little bit that they can sometimes find on defense despite the youth?
I'm sorry, I didn't quite hear the question. I'm sorry. Say it again.
Sorry. So just what, when you look at this defense and how young it is, UCF's defense, what do you look at as maybe being the key for you guys offensively and being successful against UCF?
Taking care of the football, first and foremost, and then being able to run the football, you know. And it's not just UCF. I think anybody we play, we got to be able to run the football. It's something we hadn't done over the last few weeks, and we got to do a better job of doing that first and foremost. But I think they're very well coached. I mentioned that earlier. They're very well coached, and they're very rarely out of position. So we got to be precise and sharp and play with great effort, you know, and make it count when we do get something, because they're going to be where they're supposed to be, and we got to win some one-on-one battles.
Thank you.
We'll go next to Joey Johnston with Tampa Tribune.
Willie, when you look at your offensive struggles the last month or so, you know, that Houston game stands out as sort of the thing that was different, where you were able to move the ball consistently and score and kind of dictate the other team. And the other games surrounding that, it hadn't really been the case. What happened that night that gave you success? And you know, what was it that night that you might be able to build on or kind of recapture to get the offense back on track?
Well, I thought that night our quarterback, it was his first game, no expectation, and in fact, he came out and played lights out. He went through all of his reads, and he distributed the ball amongst a lot of different receivers, and I think that's what you saw in our offense and why it went the way it did. You know, in these last couple games, of course, people seen film on Mike, but I think Mike got excited about the Houston game and got caught up in all the hype from the Houston game. I just recall, I mean, we lost that ball game, but you would have thought we won it. How excited everyone around here. Just, you know, you saw the offense, you saw Mike have success, and, you know, I think that got to Mike, and understandably so, it got to him a little bit to where he felt like he had to be the savior. And in these ball games where we're down and we need a play, he's trying to make plays. It's just he's not making the right plays for us. He's not going through his reads like he did in the Houston game, you know. And I thought this past game he was really focusing on trying to get the ball to Andre, and that got him in trouble a lot, which hurt us at times, you know. So Mike playing better and know all the things you expect from a young quarterback. Those are mistakes that he's going to make, you know, and but he's going to get better. I think if Mike would have started earlier in the year, he would be a lot better than what he's at now. Our offense would be a lot better if we had consistency at that position. But he's got to play better. He's got to go through his reads and trust that work. I mean, he know that they work and continue to distribute to the ball to the open guys, you know, and not just make up his mind where he's going to go with it. And we got to run the football better to help him. I mean, I think that's one thing that can help our offense is run the football, and something we hadn't done and that'll help Mike as well.
When you see Mike looking at these last two games and the mistakes that were made, do you see a good ability for him to process it, recognize what went wrong and correct it? Does he show that ability for a young guy?
Oh, yeah, that's what you appreciate about him. I mean, he knows exactly. He'll come to the sideline and tell you what he did wrong and what he needs to do it to correct it. And the kids continue to work. I mean, even though he hadn't been the play he was against Houston, he's continuing to work, and that's what it's going to take. I mean, he doesn't know this offense all the way. You know, he's still learning. It's a learning process for him. And like I say, he came out and had a great game against Houston, and then here comes all the expectation, and he just needs to be himself and just continue to work through and just again go through his read. Don't try to do it more. Just go through your read, and it'll happen for us.
Thank you.
Do we have any other questions for Coach Taggart, please? And Coach, thanks for your time this week. We look forward to talking to you again next Monday.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks so much.
All right,
that's, again, USF Coach Willie Taggart, the Bulls at UCF, Friday at 8 p.m. on ESPN.